to do that.
Okay, we have this sample model here. Let me show you the detail of these pools here. Let me select this and let me create a section box around it, and let me adjust the section box here, and let me make it a little bit deeper to see the details here. Now you can see we have a bottom floor, we have the walls, and also we have a thin floor here, which is we have assigned the water material to it. It is really thin, but it makes the work. And also you can create the thickness of this thin floor as thick as this hay, but it doesn't affect on your rendering. You just can create a schedule for your required water for your swimming pools with this method if you would create the thickness as thick as this head here. Okay, let's create the swimming pools. Let me turn off this section box here. I'm going to create the swimming pool in empty space, like maybe here. Let me create a section box and let me adjust it to have a smaller environment to be much comfortable to work with. Okay, it is great. Let me make it a little bit deeper. And now we can start our works. Because these are floors, we can use shaft for our void. If it was a topography, you need to use from building pads. Okay, it is great. I know the levels of this floor. It is on level 0, so I'm going to set my work plan on level 0. And then let's go to the top view, and let's go to the architecture tab. Let me use shaft tool to create the shape of our pool. You can create any shape you want. It doesn't really have any limitation. Okay, it is good for me, and click on OK, and let me adjust the height of this shaft to a little bit deeper. Okay, it is great for now. We can adjust it later according to the bottom floor. Okay, let's go to the top view again, and let me create the bottom floor from here. Let me choose one floor strip here. It is great. Okay, now we can pick line this edge, and now I press tab twice to get all of the lines. You can see the floor because the shaft has been cut the floor right now, because our floor is at the level 0 again. So let me bring it down a little bit, maybe 2 meters. That would be good. And let me make my shaft much smaller to don't cut our bottom floors. Okay, it is great now. And for the margin of this pool, we can use walls. Let's go to the architecture tab, and let me create a wall for around. So let's go to the top view, and in architecture tab, let's create a wall here. I'm going to use wall tool here. Okay, this wall is great, and you can use with pick line. I'm going to put that wall thickness in the inner side of this pool, so our exterior side of this pool. So I'm sorry. Okay, it is great. And for this side too, let me pick this one. Okay, and now for the let's go to 3D and see the heads of this. And for the head, I'm going to use from attach tools. Let me attach the base to this floor, and let me attach the top to this floor. Okay, it is great now. Okay, now this is great, but for the water part, we need a model in place, because we can't create that with floor, because the shaft will cut that too. So I'm going to create a model in place from here, put it on any category except floor. I'm going to use generic model, and then we create extrusion at the top of the swimming pool for our water material. Let me go to the extrusion tool, and let me pick this edge here. Let me create a extrusion here. Press on finish, and now you can adjust the thickness of this extrusion. Put it on wireframe to see the edge, and okay. And now we can adjust the height of this swimming pool very easily in here. Okay, this is great. I think it's going to work well. Okay, it is great. And let me choose it, and let's change the material of this to a water material. Let me search water material here, and let me put it on water material, and it is good. Okay, this is the first approach. Let me press finish here, and let's go to check the second approach. For the second approach, all you need is modeling page. Go to the modeling page, put on any category you want. You can name it. Let me name it swimming pool, and press on OK. Okay, let's go to the top menu, top view, and let's create a big box here for our size. Doesn't really matter the thickness of this. Okay, it is good. And let me assign a grass to it. Let me select this and assign a grass to this box here. From here, search grass, and let me select this one. Okay, this is great. And now we need a void to make this empty for ourselves. You can create the shape of your swimming pool here. Let me split this one and this one, and then trim them with TR. And now click on finish and adjust your height of your swimming pool with these numbers here. Maybe 3 meter would be great for me. Okay, it is great. And also you can assign other kind of materials to this side of this section box with paint tool very easily. And then you need to create another extrusion for the water material at the top of this. You can pick these edges and click on finish. And let me adjust the thickness of this water here. And now you can assign the water material again to this. And from here, click on OK. And now you're good to go. These were very simple, but you've got the point. And from now on, all of the things depends on your creativity and on your